Smell that now, tell me that's not Chardonnay, come on.
I mean, it's got oak in it.
It's got oak in it, yeah. But I reckon this is like a, it's a bit of a sleeper. And after seeing that wine, I'm gonna make a bit of a shout, perhaps maybe these are all orange wines.
Oh, it is Chardonnay.
Why do you guys ever listen to me, like, honestly? G'day guys, welcome back to another episode of Wine for the People's Blind Wine Tasting, our quest to find the most interesting wines for you to drink and also potentially give our videographer heat stroke by shooting these in a big tin shed in the Adelaide Hills these days. Huge shout out to Different Drop. The last couple of weeks have been absolutely insane. They're sorting us out with themed brackets each week. If you head over to their website, there's actually a Wine for the People collection page where you can get 10% off any of the wines we've tasted as long as they're available with the code WFTP. Now, the guys have told us that they're choosing these wines based not only on what they've got in stock, but on how interesting they are. So some of these might be limited, so you should get in quick if you are keen to taste any of these. But again, 10% off with WFTP, they've already got good prices on there, so it's a win-win, really. Without further ado, though, let's hop into this week's wines.
Wine number one, absolute crystal clear.
Really? This looks completely colourless. There's only the hint of sort of golden highlights to this.
Oh, lemony, very lemony. No, that was gonna be a terrible joke there for a second, like lemon. Series of unfortunate events. Anyway, lemony snicket, ugh, gross.
And that kind of backs up on the palate. Love this kind of like talcum powder, like lime juice acidity that kind of just charges down the palate, which is what I look for in really good Australian Riesling.
Give me Riesling vibes, but like young, youthful, and Australian as well, Australian Riesling.
Super pear-y. So like lemon, pear. I'm into it.
Gorgeous, fun, juicy, yum, really pristine, tight acid line. I do think it's Riesling. I think it's Eden Valley Riesling.
You can get some bargains. I'm gonna go $22. I'm gonna go 12. I'm gonna go one. I'm gonna go Watervale. Rizza, let's have a punt. Clack, cracking wine. Bang. This forever. This will age well as well. Just a brilliant, brilliant wine.
Two. Golden hued, like really golden. Like, you know, I've just had a ton of asparagus and tuber rock is golden.
Same color as my ring, which is probably a more palatable description as opposed to piss. It's not, it's gold like nice jewelry.
Love that, really, really, oh yeah, love that. 12 bags straight out the gate for that one. No whackers, $50 please. I'm not even gonna try guess what this is because it's an oxidative something.
Look, it smells like Chardonnay and I think it's because it smells oaky, but I think it's masquerading as something else. The color doesn't seem right, there's green highlights. Lights, but it's really golden. Usually when it's really golden, like those green highlights are faded. I think it's another variety and potentially like Roussan.
Ooh, yeah, that's cool. I'm sticking with Chardonnay because it has all the characteristics I'm looking for, but then it's got all this other excitement and difference going on in there that I wouldn't usually expect from the variety. As we all know, it's not my favorite thing to drink in the world, so I'm only gonna have 3 bottles of it.
Absolutely give this a crack if you do like those kind of really complex, nutty, oxidative styles of wine. And the oak use here is really, really nice. Cracking, cracking. They've done it again.
One number three, yeah, like nectar.
Oh yeah, it smells like it's an absolute apricot. It is the epitome of an apricot. Just so beautifully, like it's got this like furriness, but it's got this like light, vibrant acidity.
That's natural, that's very natural. Unironically smells like my, the compost bin, like that I have at home.
Really gorgeous, full sourness that really defines the palate. Not in a really unappealing way, like in a really, you know, beautiful and sort of new world contemporary way.
Natty apricots. It's obviously $38, as we always talk about, and I'll have 6 bottles of that one. If it smelled better, I'd have 12, but I'll have 6.
It's got this like peach Zappo, like turbocharged acidity that's just so fun. And then there, that apricot flavor is just well and truly there. And the tannin profile is just scrumptious.
I do think this is probably like a Viognier Sauvignon Blanc blend. And it's pretty delicious. I'm gonna drop around about $38 and I'm gonna buy 3. Moving on to wine number 4. We've got 3 red wines coming up, and this one already looks delicious. It's light in color.
Based on my deductions, this is gonna be a straight up and down, just like your dad was raised on, squeaky clean red wine.
Yeah, that pepperiness is like really around the fruit. You can, there's a like nice kind of like plum, blackberry, cherry thing going on. There's like nice kind of brambly fruits.
Yeah, wow. like cracker. Absolutely cracking Pinot Noir. I would drop $65 a bottle on that.
A little bit of tannin on the back end, not much acidity. Could be Grenache, could be Sangio. I'm gonna go with Sangio on that one.
Bitterness of the tannin profile and the pepperiness is kind of detracting. I feel like you get this like really peppery finish, which is not the most pleasing thing for me.
I would buy 12. I just think that's all class. Obviously, winemakers have pulled their hair out over the viticulture of this and winemaking of this. If it was a couple of weeks ago, I probably would have called this like 80, 90 to 120 bucks, but this 65, I'm kind of vibing, is gonna be where it comes out at.
One number five, like the last two reds from last week, that sort of like thick, plummy, bright red, but also hazy throughout the whole thing.
There's this balsamic thing that's really quite appealing and delicious. It's got some tannin there too. I don't know, it could be like an Aussie Nebbiolo.
Beautiful. I still think it's Pinot. Like it could be, you could think it's Grenache, you could think it's something like that, but there is like a lower acidity, but I really think this is a hands-off producer that has picked Pinot flavor rightness, that decided not to add acidity or not that much.
Quite similar to the previous one. Still got this like spicy finish to it. And I'm not gonna lie, right now, in the current climate that we're in, being 32 degrees in the shed, in the Adelaide Hills with no insulation, it's not the sort of wine I want to be drinking right now, man. It is tough to get through that sort of stuff.
Quick, easy drinking, not seriousness, just really good times, and I quite like it. But Chebec's with the variety, we're a bit more challenged here. I'm not exactly sure what it is, but could be anything, but I rather enjoy it. I hope it can be at an affordable price for me to chug in a tumbler.
Wine number six, we're going something that is dense, dark, brick, tawny, hued. I'm already getting Nebbiolo vibes. Let's get a sniffy sniff going.
Smells promising. Very lavendery, like big lavender on the nose, actually. Writing that one down, the boys will be very impressed.
I'm gonna go old school Grenache for me, because it's definitely got that ripeness. I'm gonna go Barossa, because that kind of reminds me of some kind of classic, like really strawberry rich Barossa Grenaches, where you get that overripeness because it's such a hot region.
There's something about this, the style of the acidity, that really kind of tells me that this is probably Australian, just done really, really like well from a cool-ish climate, but can achieve full ripeness, so probably not Tassie.
Yeah, like it lots. Varietally, I'm gonna go with Gamay again, but I'm more confident about it this time around. Last time was a bit of a stab in the dark, and this one is a $50 bottle of wine.
All the wines are great, all the wines are interesting, and all the wines are really delicious. There's just that there's some peaks and valleys here.
But turn the fans on is all I have to say. Like, you turn the goddamn fans on, take my shirt off. This is ridiculous. Oh my God. Alrighty, week three in the new shed. How did you guys find this lineup?
I absolutely loved all three of the whites, and I was somewhat indifferent to the reds.
As usual, Noah, I am the complete opposite to you. I'm the complete opposite to you. I love the reds. I thought the reds were fantastic. The whites are the ones I struggled with.
I've got no idea what half of these are, to be honest.
Oh yeah, no. I'm stumped.
Do you have any guesses on bracket?
My only guess was like new school Barossa.
Could be on it.
Yeah, I have no idea. Nah. It sounds good though. Let's see if you're right. Wine number one, Riesling, I thought.
Yeah, it looks very much like Riesling.
$45, how many did you guys
take? I had a dozen for 22.
And a dozen for 20. Dozens all round.
Dozens, what we got?
30, right in the middle of everyone.
Not bad
at all. Ah, it is, it's Riesling.
It's Riesling, but it's from Orange.
From Orange. Oh, it's that famous orange wine.
You're allowed one of those.
Serious consequences, my friend. Yeah, 880 meters above sea level.
That is
some elevation, man.
That's ski season.
That is some elevation. Up to 980 meters above sea level. That is incredible.
How good?
$30, bargain. Wine number two, first time I've called Chardonnay in the new joint. How'd you guys think?
Could be. I didn't have a guess of variety. It was just too oxidative and like tertiary for me. So there's like this nutty thing. So I was like,
smell that now. Tell me that's not Chardonnay. Come on.
I mean, it's got oak in it.
It's got oak in it.
Yeah.
But I reckon this is like it's a bit of a sleeper. And after seeing that wine, I'm going to make a bit of a shout. Perhaps maybe these are all orange wines.
That would be very fitting. Yeah, one orange wine and then five wines from orange. $50 for me. I went 12.
$3.45.
$3.32. $50.
Fitty.
Is it from orange?
Is it Roussard?
Oh, it's Latta. Oh, it is Chardonnay.
Have you guys ever listened to me? Like, honestly, I know that I'm here to be like the everyman, but sometimes just smell what's there and then be like, well, that's Chardonnay.
Amazing. Well. So yeah, this is
what he calls Jurassic. So it's Jura-style Chardonnay, oxidatively handled, but Chardonnay as well, made in Victoria, and it's Owen Latta at his absolute very, very best.
I love the fact that on the back it says soil free draining red buckshot soil.
Number three, obviously we're getting into that orange wine territory now. I thought it was just natural apricots all round.
So good. Yeah.
Hated the smell of it, loved the taste of it, as is so often the case with me with this style of wine.
I was the opposite.
Really?
Loved the smell, the taste of it sort of really sort of vexed me a little bit.
Because it's natty, I thought it was $38 and I wanted six of them.
Yeah,
of
course. I went 38 too,
and
I went
magic
12.
Number 38 and six.
Lucky. Budget.
Yes, it's budget magic.
Morange. Victoria.
So is the theme is it the theme that there's like orange on the bottle there? Like it's got an orange neck label. The other wine's from orange. This is an orange wine.
Oh my god, I think we got
this. This is getting meta.
This is getting crazy. Yes.
That's super fun. What was the variety on this? L'Orange?
Couldn't tell you.
I actually thought it was like a Viognier Sauvignon.
Didn't
Blanc.
We have?
Might be Shannon. Shannon from. Yeah.
Am I crazy or did we have one by that producer? Last night.
Flora.
Yeah. That was tasty as well.
That was Riesling.
He makes very tasty wine.
Yeah. There you go.
And very good value that. Too.
I'm going to say the theme is orange.
Yeah.
So what's the theme for the reds though?
I said Sangio on wine number four just because I didn't really have any other variety to throw at it.
I said Pinot. And $65 and 12.
Whoa.
Jeez, I thought it was stunning. I thought it was too peppery, and I went Cap Franc.
All about it.
Cool.
All about it.
I quite liked it. Needed three bottles of it. This is not exactly my style, but $45.
Oh, it was pretty much the same. Three bottles at 40.
12 and 65.
Yeah, right. How much, what? Nice lot.
Oh, it is Pinot. And it is from Tasmania.
Yeah. Fantastic. Shiny. James Scott. Studied with him, actually. Amazing winemaker. And it's really cool to see his wines actually over here as well. We don't really see them. So there's not that much that are actually made, to be honest.
As
you know, cracking little fun numbers. Certainly
good.
Spicy as well.
Very
so
spicy.
I think a really deft use of whole bunch.
Yeah, I agree.
Done really well. A sort of cedar box thing.
One on five. This is probably my least favorite of the lineup, I'd have to say.
I actually quite enjoyed this.
I'm a 12 bagger on that one too.
The variety really threw me. I couldn't pick it.
$38, magic number. 12 bottles.
I
loved it.
32 and 6.
I was at 1 and 33. Hey! One thing, right?
I was $1 off.
What?
What is that?
Nuovo.
That's an echidna.
Wine of Australia.
Label's cool. Don't like what's
the I'm going to say it was Pinot. I was right.
Okay. Fancy that?
Well, let's find out with the last one.
Yeah, which I reckon is also Pinot.
Ripe?
Yeah, super ripe.
This smells incredible.
It
smells bonkers. It smells like lavender.
It's jam.
Yeah.
It's strawberry jam.
Yeah.
What's really interesting, super ripe on the nose, really high acid. So I'm not too sure whether it's coming from like a really warm vintage or like warm area and they've dosed it up with acidity because the acid's really quite peaky.
But 6 for 35. I thought it was Barossa.
A dozen for 50. I
a dozen really for 90.
It. Ooh, bargain.
There you go, 35. Ah, there you go, Breaking Shiraz down. From Hunter Valley. The furthest thing from Piyarra Pinot.
Yeah, 100%.
You can probably get 100%.
I've seen this is Ollie Margan stuff.
This is Ollie Margan, so.
Yeah, very exciting.
So basically working within the Margan family, doing his own little side project with a lot of organically farmed fruit that they look after. This is his Shiraz. He does Barbera, some Semillon, of course. And Albarino, but this is an interesting take on Hunter Shiraz. It doesn't have a lot of the characters that I would naturally associate with it, but I still quite like drinking it.
So I really like the label on that. It's my sort of thing.
Question. Theme.
I have no idea. Lockie?
Do we know what the theme is?
I have no idea what this is. Okay, yeah.
That makes sense.
Warren's a risen star. Latta's
risen star. Pretty rose. Yeah.
He is. They are high in the sky.
Yeah.
One of the week.
Democracy says the Riesling. We all bought a dozen.
I really like the Riesling. I also think that like right now it's the most drinkable.
Oh, yeah.
It's the one I want to drink the most right now, which is really helping.
That would be very refreshing.
Which is really helping.
But there's some bangers in there as well.
Yeah. And thanks for joining us again this week, guys. Don't forget, 10% off all these wines on the collection page on different drops. WFTP at checkout. See you next time.
Have a good.